I don't see constraint anymore. There are no more constraints on liquidity. I think now the market has been flushed with more liquidity lately. We noticed that, for example, interbank rates dropped from around 4.3% two years ago during in the midst of the crisis to around 1.8% lately. So I think there is a major decrease in interbank rate, which is a sign of a liquid market, as we see. And this was due to the intervention of the central bank during the crisis, one by the injection, liquidity injection that they have done, and two by bank guarantees that they have introduced, guaranteeing bank deposits during the crisis. These two regulations, these two activities have clearly helped the market and helped the liquidity in the market, and we don't see the dryness of liquidity that we see, that we saw in the during the crisis, and therefore we will expect that credit will be increasing, and that is clear also if we look at the level of deposits versus the level of finance. During the crisis in 2008, finance was more than deposits, whereas now I think deposits is around 1.1 trillion dirhams, and we have a finance of around 95% of that, which means that we will see soon an increase. I think we have started to see a considerable increase in lending in the market. Yes, I think UAE banks have before the crisis, have very much relied on international capital market to finance their tenor mismatches between the long term, between the short term and the long term financing they have. And I think this has been probably slowed down during the crisis because unavailability of the capital market. Now the capital market is back again, and I think with the investor confidence in the UAE and the UAE banking sector, we could see we probably have seen even some banks going back to the capital market to raise some funds, and we'll continue to see that trend until a local or a regional market has been is available for us to tap on. So in April, Mubadala retested the market with an issuance of $750 million, very well received. And in May, there was Sharjah Islamic Bank, Islamic Development Bank, Abu Dhabi Islamic Bank early this year. Just last week, HSBC has also come to the market. They were all well received. There were an oversubscription in most of them. In all of them, added five times, I think Sharjah Islamic eight times, and a few other multiples. So the market is looking for the and expecting a growth in the bond market. Irrespective of where we're going there, I think it's very important to sit back and review and analyze thoroughly what's happening in Europe. You know, with the sovereign debt crisis of Europe, and with some calls of breaking up the euro zone into various euro categories, I think that should make us think and analyze of possible that this could be a potential problem that we will face in the future with the single currency, the GCC. So we need to be ready to take such actions in the future if a crisis happens. We need to be behind the various GCC members to bail them out or to support any debt crisis they have in order to support this common currency that we are going to build. So we need to currently review what's happening here. I think what's happening in Europe provide lots of lessons for us as we are developing the common currency in the future. I think federal unity in the UAE has proven itself during the crisis and post-crisis. It was very clear that the crisis has hit hard home. throughout, you know, liquidity, we discussed it earlier. There are many other sectors that have been hit hard by the crisis. Yet we haven't seen any defaults. We haven't seen any bankruptcies, major bankruptcies. We haven't seen a major disruption to the economy in the UAE. On the contrary, I think UAE has passed through the crisis relatively unharmed. The UAE also, it's proven again after this geopolitical issues that surround us as a strong and a safe haven for investors and is becoming a flight to quality market. And this, in my opinion, is strongly a direct result of the federal unity. And that proved itself very clearly. And usually you test unity during tough times. And I think we went through tough times, two tough times on the financial side and on the political side, and we came out very strongly and made the name strong. And I think we emphasized the strength of the UAE.